star drive and light. The color of a photon depends on its shape. This might sound strange, but it's true. You got two gravitons, spring-like, and when they're like this, it's violet, yellow, and red. Violet, small one. This is a green one, the bigger. They don't all have the same length, those quarks. Photons cartoon through space. Since the average speed of gravitons is the same for both the short and the long quark, or photon, both propel through space at the same speed. However, the short photon has to spin in a higher pace when covering the same distance. The difference in size makes certain frequencies penetrate deeper than others. So we got this one has a higher frequency, shorter wavelength, longer wavelength, because it's just bigger. It's a bigger quark. This is a down quark, it's a up quark, but it's all, nothing is black and white, of course. You see the average speed is 1C, speed of light, and that's how I got to 2 times the speed of light for a graviton, because the graviton propels photons through space. This one is now the slow one, so this one is now the positron, this one is the electron, and every time these two change positions. This one goes from fast to slow, to fast to slow, to fast to slow, and that creates the magnetic field in that direction, because a fast or a slow one has an influence when it gets hit from the side on the speed of these spring type rotations, neutrino, antineutrino, whatever you want to call it. Next picture is how our eyes see light. This is the human eye. These are cylinders, and it's well known the human eye has cylinders and cones. And the cylinders are for night vision. They can measure the intensity of light, and they are calibrated for yellow. Yellow moonlight, you know, that's what they calibrate for. And they calculate the amount of light. Well, when it connects these two neurons or synapses, it's good, 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 bad. This one doesn't connect either. This one is a mismatch. So the cylinders count the number of light. Reds are too big, they cannot penetrate, so a red light is ideal for diode submarines and for diodes in cars, because it cannot saturate these cylinders. Here are the cones, and we use them for color detection, and they work best under daylight. Again, here's one who mismatches, but you can see a cone can measure the size, the actual size of a photon. And this is not a joke, this is how it works. And depending on the many he detects, he says, oh, well, that's violet, and that's, oh, that's for blue. You know, it's electrical.